Okay. So still waiting on the new sentence boundary detection model to keep training, but off camera I was thinking about this a bit, and I think I can start on the inference component. So essentially the tricky problem is that we have a sentence, and then it's going to detect the sentence boundary, but the characters it outputs before that boundary might not be identical. But it would still like point out what we would think of as the right point in the text. So I think to deal with this, we're going to need some concept of string similarity. And doing a bit of research, it seems like Python has this difflib in the standard library, which would be great if we could just use something in the standard library and not have to worry about it too much. So okay, so this seems like what we want. This shouldn't take very long, so I'm not too worried. So I'm assuming they're expecting, okay, next, just two strings. So what's ratio? Oh, perfect, this is exactly what we want. Okay, so this is exactly what we want to do. SM dot set sequences hello world goodbye world, and then sm.ratio 58. One. Oh, perfect. Okay, this is perfect. So no new dependencies. We don't have to think much about it. So this is sentence boundary detection. So we're just going to modify the experimental one for now. So this is a little tricky. We need to get it access to the packages. So it should be installed. Okay, so I think we should just def get SVD translation. So then we want to make a packaged translation. Okay, so we want to copy this. Language of codes equals dict for package in packages. So we should define these constants. From lang equals SVD from to line code. SVD two, okay. Package up from code does not equal sentence boundary from code. And package. To code. Okay, so if package from code isn't the from code, so if package.fromCode is not sentence boundary from code, and package to code is sentence boundary to code. This stuff. Um, Oh, so this is important too. I don't really even need this. Package translation. And does it make sense to cache this? Okay, so we do need to get packages somehow. Okay, so we get the installed packages, and then we try to find the sentence boundary detection package, and then we make a translation out of it, and then we return it. Otherwise, we return them. Okay. That seems good. This seems good. Package translate. Okay. So then to use this, translation equals get SPD. And then pull up the docs. So this is a iTranslation. Which means we can, so if we wanted to get more involved, we could use multiple hypotheses, but I think we could just do this. Let's for now just try to split the first sentence off. So we need some guess of what we're going to try. So let's say guess. Equals. Let's go back to let's find some sentences. One twenty-three. 116. So it seems 150 is probably going to reasonably get most sentences. Okay. And then we want to run the translation. SVG translated guess equals SVG translation translate guess. Okay, so this is the length we're going to guess. We're going to get the translation. We're going to make the guess. We're going to log it. And then we're going to run it through the model, and let's log that too. Guess. Okay. And then to compute the similarity so now we want to find the index where the token is. Find substring. So SVD guess SVD translated guess is we're gonna need this token too. Oh no, this is different. Shoot. So we need the we need the we need the tokens that actually go through the model. So we actually want to detect sentence. Token. Okay. Okay, so we're going to find the token. If index is not equal to negative one, this is where we do this stuff, and then otherwise, we're just going to not do it for now. Okay. And then guess equals SPD translated guess. SPD hated guess index. Okay, so this should be what it's guessing. This is what's coming out of the model, where it what it thinks it is, and then we want to loop through. The actual text and try to mash them up. Candidate sentence equals so we're all, this is all just the first sentence at this point. So it's input text to the, oh no, no, it's, oh no, it is the input, so it's the input text to I. So this is the actual input, so we're going through the input text now, and finding a candidate sentence, and now we want to compute how similar this is to SPD translated guess. Okay. So, We need to import this, but then commands manager dot set seeks candidate sentence to SVD estimated guess. And then ratio equals sm.ratio. Okay. So best index equals none. Best ratio equals zero. And then if best index is none, or ratio is greater than best ratio, then best index is I, and the best ratio is ratio. Okay, and so this gives us our detected sentence of input text input text. We can simplify this. Actually, no, let's keep it with the ratio. Detected sentence to best index, and then we will print this detected. For detected sentence. Okay. So these info debugs will only print if debug is true. Okay. Okay, so we had an issue in get SVD translation. Frumlang is not defined. Oh, yeah. SVD from code. SVD to code. And we should also exclude these from, well, I think we'd want to exclude these so they don't appear on the list that users see, but for now we probably do want to see them. Okay, so let's get some text. I think there's an infinite loop because this is slowed down a lot. Okay, I think the issue I think it was an infinite recursion because we're like every time we call a model we need to we're calling translate on it, Okay, so we want to not do sentence boundary detection when we're running the sentence boundary detection model. Okay. If package dot from code is BD from code, then no sentence boundary detection. Then if that's not true and it's experimental, then we're going to do our thing, and otherwise it's just going to run stanza. Okay, so we seem to not be going crazy at least. So let's see what we get. Oh, so we should actually use a real language then. Okay, so we're gonna try to translate English to Spanish, but it's gonna use the sentence boundary detection model, but only for the first sentence. So it seems to just kind of crashed. Oh yeah, we forgot to import this. From difflib import sequence matcher. Detected sentence is not defined. Oh yeah, it's equal to the input text. Local variable. Oh, this should be. And then print sentences equals detected. So what we're hoping this will do is that if we translate a sentence and a half of English, it'll come out as a single sentence of Spanish. Okay. And it seems to have worked. We lost the period, it looks like. Okay. So now we need to be able to do longer pieces of text. Okay. So I'm gonna I'm just gonna just add this so it's an easy place to get back to. Okay, so this is a little tricky because we need to detect each sentence, which I think should at this point be its own function. So this will just, for a single sentence, maybe just return the index. That's probably what we actually are going to want. Okay, so input text, given input text, return the index, after the end of the first sentence. Args input text is a string that text to detect of okay. Input text, SPD translation, you may want to cache this too. Okay, so this should all still work. Else turn -1. And then we're going to use the text sentence. Okay. So we still don't want to do it for the sentence boundary ones, and then, okay, so, sentences. I should pass in the sentence guess line. Oh, I just hard coded. Sentence guess. Okay. And we'll default it to 150. Actually, I think we could do something where you keep trying longer lengths if it doesn't work, but for now I think I'm just gonna take one shot at it, and then otherwise I'll just cut it at 150. While true, index equals text sentence input text start index I want all of it. Okay, so we're gonna get the index. So if SPD so for this we just want something that it won't mess up too many sentences, and so an average was like 120, so I'll just do 110 and we'll just cut it. Sys plus equals input text start index to SVD index. Start index plus. Okay. So we are going to loop through so while start index is less than so if it's a length 3 and the start index is 2, yeah, because we want at least one character there. Okay. Index equals start index equals SVD index. Okay, let's see how that does. Okay, so start index must be of none type. I don't actually return it. Okay. So we want to go English to Spanish. And so let's just start with the case from before. So something seemed to be infinitely looping. So I guess we can run the sentence boundary one just to see if it's broken somehow. So that seems to work. Which, yeah, it was working before. Sentence guess. Detect sentence boundary. Let's try looking through the logs better. So English to Spanish. Okay, so this is where it actually starts. So interesting, it didn't detect sentences. Oh, this is another run. Okay, here it goes. Okay. So this is the text we entered. It applies the package translation. It makes a sentence guess. Oh, which barely missed. Maybe we should remember this, but try a slightly shorter sentence. So this is also not working. Okay. So this is the test. Okay. So this is what we passed in. And then it guesses something reasonable. Not sure why we see this again then. Apply package translation. And this doesn't belong. Oh, no, this makes sense. Oh, so this is the call to the sentence boundary detection model, which then doesn't get sentence boundary detected intentionally. It gets tokenized. You can see here, this is where we told sentence piece not to break this up. You can skip the hypothesis stuff. So this seems to go wrong. SPD translated guess seems right, and then the sentence guess is the next sentence. Maybe we flipped a, okay, so SPD translated guess is right, and then then the sentence guess. Oh, so this could just be the sequence matcher going wrong. Sentence guess. Oh, no, this is probably it trying to do the next one. So this is the next step in the while loop. So that would be right then. So it correctly identified the sentence, went on to the next one. Oh, and so it starts doing crazy stuff when it goes further in the while loop. So it comes up with this very long thing. Well, what do we want to happen? We want when it hits the end, it should just either fail to place a token and then just auto cut it, or I suppose it would place a token either at the end or eventually short. Okay, I think I should add some more logging around the while loop. Okay. Okay. Print. Start index. Print the index. And then okay. Print input text from the start index, the SPD index. Okay. And then I'll disable the other login. So actually, I want to try something longer then. Okay, This should give us information. Start index 0, SPD. So it nails the first sentence. Start index 134. Oh, so this is where it's going wrong. Because SPD index equals is actually this start index plus this because the when we're actually trying to detect in-detect sentence, it's going to all be relative. So is this working, though? The first daemon, so it gets the first sentence. Small navy. Okay. In 1815, the company built the early submarine. Yeah, it gets the second one. It had been intended to build the boats in... Moves to... Oh, so I bet this actually went under. So I think maybe this should be a bit higher. But this seems to work then. Next. So I think I'll stop this video here and then do another one once the model finishes fully training to really see what it can do. Thanks for watching.